These three contestants are about to play the most exciting game of their lives, which only one of them can win. Robert Annis is our returning champion, who has already won $9,818. Dave Meltzer is a publisher's representative from Brentwood, who wants to replace Robert and become today's champ. And Shirley Sprinkles is a school teacher from Tucson, Arizona, who has the same ambitions. From Television City in Hollywood, it's time to press your luck. And now, here's your host, the star of Press Your Luck, Peter DeMarkin. Thank you.
Thank you, Rod Roddy, and welcome to Press Your Luck, the most competitive game in television where players take big risks for big bucks. And now let's learn a little something about the three very competitive players who are going to be pressing their luck today, starting with Dave.
Well, I'm a publisher's representative. I'm from Los Angeles, and I used to be a blackjack dealer in Lake Tahoe.
What happened? You lose?
No, they had to let me go. I was too generous.
Too bad you're not still there, Dave.
Yeah.
A lot of people like that.
Mm-hmm.
All right, well, welcome to Press Your Luck, and let's meet Shirley.
Hi, I combine two careers. I'm school teacher and I design and manufacture a line of children's wear. But the most important thing is that I have four children of my own, and the tallest is 6 feet five.
That's a tall child, and the others are shorter.
I hope to win a stool so I can kiss him.
All right, well, good luck to you, Shirley. And our returning champion, Robert, with $9,818.
Here I am again.
Well done, Robert. Now, I understand, Robert, that you have an interesting education. Tell us about it.
Well, I graduated from high school at the age of 15, and I started going to university. I'm now in my third year of college, and I just turned 18.
What, are you retired at about 21 or so?
I plan to go to Harvard if I can keep my GPA up.
All right, well, you're making enough money, you'll be able to afford it.
Yeah, that's the
thing. All right, good luck. Players, I'm going to ask you four questions, and your correct answers will earn you spins of the big Press Your Luck game board. The more spins you have, the more money you can win, because our board is loaded with thousands of dollars in cash and fabulous prizes. And every time you stop the board like this, stop, you'll win money, or you'll do what I just did, which is to hit a whammy. And beware the whammy who lives on the board, lest he deliver you into bankruptcy. In other words, he'll take away all your money. So you want to avoid that, okay? The player with the most money at the end of the game gets to keep it all, go back home, and come back tomorrow and play again. Isn't that exciting? All right, are you all ready to press your luck?
Yes.
All right, here's your first question. In the world of employment, what job do the most women hold? Dave.
Teacher.
Teacher, Dave says. If Dave is right, he will pick up three spins. I will give Dave's answer and two others to Shirley and Robert. If they're right, they'll pick up a spin apiece. Dave said teacher. Or is it waitresses or secretaries? Shirley?
I say waitresses.
Shirley goes with waitresses as well, and we're going to go over to Robert to see what he says.
I'm going to go with secretary.
Secretaries. Well, what job do the most women hold? It is secretaries. Robert's right. What a start. All right. Dave gets no spins. Shirley gets no spins. Robert picks up one and goes to one. All right, Robert's in the lead. Here's our second question. Each year, the average American consumes 120 pounds of this vegetable, and it's a good source of fiber. It's low in protein, but also low in fat. What is it? Shirley.
Cereal.
Cereal, Shirley says. All right, is the correct answer. Cereal. Carrots. Potatoes. Dave?
Potatoes.
Dave says potatoes. All right. And Shirley said cereal. We'll go over to Robert. What do you say, Robert?
Carrots.
Carrots, Robert says. Well, that cereal that's low in fat is potatoes. And Dave gets one. So Dave goes to one spin. Shirley stays at zero, and Robert stays at one spin. And here's our third question. In the town of Hannibal, they celebrate Tom Sawyer Days every July. In what state will you find this Hannibal? Dave?
Missouri.
Missouri, Dave says. Is the correct answer Missouri, Mississippi, or Louisiana, Shirley?
I'll go with Missouri.
You're going to go with Missouri, too. Okay, it's two for Missouri. What about you, Robert?
Three for Missouri.
Three for Missouri. Ordering up one Missouri. You are all correct. It is Missouri. And that means Dave buzzed in and picked up three, goes to four spins. Shirley's right, picks up a spin, goes to one. Robert picks up a spin and goes to two spins. And here we are with our fourth and final question. Critical question. So far, of the 11 movies he's made, which Woody Allen film has been the most commercially successful? Dave?
Annie Hall.
Annie Hall, says Dave. Is the correct answer Annie Hall, Manhattan, or Sleeper, Shirley?
Annie Hall.
Shirley goes with Annie Hall, and we're going to go over to Robert and see what he says.
Annie Hall.
Three Annie Halls. You all saw it. Well, you're all correct. It is Annie Hall. Yeah. And that means that was the last question. Dave picks up three spins and goes to seven. Shirley picks up a spin and goes to two. Robert picks up a spin and goes to three. And you're all going to have a chance to convert your spins into big dollars at the exciting Trust Your Luck game board right after this. All right, we're back. And players, as you can see, there are prizes, surprises, and over $13,000 in cash, and of course, a few whammies up there on that game board. So each time you spin, you have a chance to add anywhere from $100 to $1,250 to your total, and you'll notice that our board is constantly changing. So if you kind of feel a whammy coming on and you don't want to press your luck, all you got to do is pass your remaining spins to another player during your turn, and you can protect your money that way. All right, remember, everything is at stake each time you spin, and four whammies put you out of the game, so you want to be aware of that. All right, the player with the fewest spins is Shirley, and you have the dubious distinction of beginning to press your luck. Are you ready, Shirley, with two spins?
I'm ready.
All right, here we go.
Stop.
Stop. Oh, well. Well, he was just lurking in the bushes, Shirley, waiting to jump out. But I guess if he's going to come out, he didn't really hurt you that much. You got one whammy, you didn't sacrifice any dollars, you've got one spin left. You ready to press your luck?
I'm ready.
Okay, here we go.
Stop!
$250, Shirley! That was quick. You made a comeback. $250 for Shirley. We go over to Robert with three spins and no dollars. Robert, are you ready to press your luck?
I am.
Here we go.
Stop!
Stop at a necklace, Robert. I'm sure you'll find someone to give that necklace to. Gives you a total of 515. Two spins left. You're in first place. You want to press your luck or pass?
I'll press my luck.
Here we goes.
Stop.
Stop at $650, Robert. That puts you in the four-figure range. $1,165. You have one spin left. You can press your luck or pass that spin to Shirley because Shirley has the next highest amount of money to you. If you're going to pass it, it goes to her. What are you going to do?
I'm going to pass.
You are going to pass it. Okay, yeah. It goes over to Shirley. One spin goes over in the earned column. Actually, it goes into the pass column. And Shirley, we're going to deal with you now. It's a spin that you have to take. You don't want to hit a whammy. Are you ready?
I'm ready.
You're ready. Here we go.
Stop.
Stop at an answering machine. All right, Robert's strategy didn't quite pay off. It is an answering machine for Shirley with a value of $219. Shirley, that brings you up to $469. Dave, you ready to press your luck?
I sure am.
Here we go.
Stop.
Stop at a sewing machine, Dave. Well done. Make yourself some new threads. That sewing machine has a value of $449. Congratulations. All right, that gives you a total of $449, Dave, and you have six spins left. You want to press your luck or pass?
I'll press my luck.
Gonna press. Here we go.
Stop.
Stop at uh-oh. You did it. Yeah, he came out and hexed you. That's the one that Robert was dealing with. Came to you. All right, you've got yourself five spins, no dollars, one whammy. You ready to go?
I'm ready.
Can't win the game in third place.
Stop.
Stop at $200. Making a comeback, Dave. Four spins. Press your luck or pass.
I'll press my luck.
Here we go.
Stop.
Stop at $150. That's $350. Obviously, you want to get yourself into second place before you think about passing. So what do you want to do?
I'll press my luck.
Gonna press.
Stop.
Oh. He's having a great time with you, Dave.
Yeah.
I know he is. Now you've got two whammies. You've got to be a bit more careful. Two spins, no dollars. What are you going to do?
I'll press my luck.
You're going to press his luck. Here we go.
Stop.
Stop at $750. Yeah. All right, Dave. $750. You have one spin left. You are in second place. If you pass that spin, it goes to Robert, who is in first place. $400 more than you have.
I'll pass.
You're going to pass it. All right, yeah. It goes over to Robert. Robert, $1,165 at stake. It's a spin that you have to take since it was passed. Are you ready?
Here we go.
Could increase his total, go to nothing.
Stop.
Stop at $100. You got the odds and beat him. All right, we've got Shirley at $469, Dave at $750, and Robert, you are leading with $1,265, which you'll see later is a mighty big advantage. We'll be right back with more questions, spins, prizes, and surprises right after this. Thank you, and now, players, I've got four more questions, and that means four more chances to earn some mighty big spins. Remember, the more spins you have, the more money you can win at that board. And the player with the most money at the end of this round takes what they've won home today and returns to play again tomorrow. Are we set to play our second round?
Ready. Yeah.
All right, here's your first question. What is the name of the grade that the Department of Agriculture gives to meat that is of the highest quality? USDA what? Shirley?
Prime.
Prime, Shirley said. Everybody was pushing the buzzer, but you can't get in until I finish the question. All right, Shirley. If you're right, you're going to pick up three spins. I'll give Shirley's answer and two others to Dave and Robert. If they're right, they'll pick up a spin apiece. Is the correct answer prime, choice, or fancy, Dave?
Choice.
Choice, says Dave. Shirley, of course, said prime. Robert, what do you say?
It's choice.
It is choice, Robert. Very definitive. However, the answer is prime. Oh. Shirley is right. Picks up a big three. Dave and Robert stay at zero. Shirley's got three right now. Here we go to our second question. It hasn't been that long, but what's the last name of the man who won the Oscar last spring for Best Actor? Dave.
Henry Fonda, or Fonda.
Fonda, says Dave. All right, is the correct answer Fonda, Hoffman, or Kingsley, Shirley?
It's Fonda.
Fonda, says Shirley. Robert, what do you say?
Kingsley.
Kingsley, says Robert. Well, the man who won the Oscar last spring is Ben Kingsley for Gandhi. And Robert is right. Robert is going to accept the award for Ben. All right, Dave has no spins. Shirley still has her three, and Robert picks up one and goes to one. And here we go with our third question. What are you eating if you're dining on a Santa Claus, Persian, or a honeydew? Shirley?
A melon.
A melon, says Shirley. Is the correct answer melon, apple, or onion, Dave?
Melon.
Melon, says Dave. Shirley says melon. We go to Robert. What do you say?
I'll go with melon.
You're going to go with melon? Why not? Well, a honeydew, of course, is a melon. What else would it be? Everybody's a winner on that one. That means Dave picks up a spin and goes to one. Shirley buzzed in, so she picks up three more and goes to six. Robert picks up one and goes to two. And here's our fourth and final question. It's the limousine capital of America with more than 200 limo companies. What city is it, Shirley?
Los Angeles.
Los Angeles, says Shirley. All right. Is the correct answer Los Angeles, Las Vegas, or New York? Dave?
New York.
Dave says New York. Shirley said Los Angeles. Robert, what do you say?
I'll agree with Dave, New York.
You're going to go with New York. Well, the limousine capital of the United States is indeed New York City. Yeah. Dave and Robert pick up spins. Dave goes to two spins. Shirley stays at six. And Robert picks up a spin and goes to three. And all our players will be taking those spins to the big board to decide who the winner will be on Press Your Luck right after this. Thank you. And now, players, we weren't kidding when we said earlier that you can win a bundle on Press Your Luck. Because as you can see, the value of that board has changed dramatically. Not only are the prizes even more fabulous, but there's over $50,000 in cash up there just waiting to be won. And speaking of monies, let's recap our figures. We've got Shirley at $469. We've got Dave at $750, and Robert is at $1,265. And Robert, remember I told you there's a big advantage in having the most money in round two? Yeah. Well, the advantage is that you are going to go last.
Great.
And that puts you in a great position here. And as the champ, you know about that. Now we're going to go over and deal with the player with the least money, which is Shirley. But you've got a lot of spins, Shirley. $469, six spins. Are you ready to press your luck?
I'm really ready.
Here we go.
Okay. Stop.
Stop! Oh, what a place to stop. I think he trimmed you a bit, Shirley. You've got $0, two whammies. You want to watch out for that. And you've got five spins, and you're in third place. What are you going to do?
I'm going to press my luck.
Pressing her luck. Here goes Shirley. No more whammies.
Stop
at a sailboat. Well done, Shirley. A sailboat. Value of $1,379 with one spin. You put yourself into first place. You've got two whammies, four spins. You can press your luck or pass those spins to Robert, who has the second highest amount of money to
I'm
you.
I'm going to press my luck.
I'm going to press. Here we go.
Stop
it. Move one space to $1,200 or $500 and pick up a spin. Which would you rather have?
Let me have $1,200.
You've got it. $1,200 for Shirley. $2,579 first place. About $1,300 more than Robert. You've got three spins. Press your luck or pass.
I pass to Robert, right?
You're going to pass them.
To Robert?
Yes, Shirley, if you are passing, you would have to pass to Robert because he's the player with the next highest amount of money.
To Robert?
Yes. Are you going to pass?
Okay, I pass.
Going to pass those spins to Robert. Here they come. All three of them come to the champ. And it means you got to take them, but you're not going to take them now.
I know.
Because you're the last player to play your spin, so you can sit back and contemplate while we go over and chit-chat with Dave, who's got $750 and two spins. You are in third place, Dave. Are you ready to press your luck?
I'll press my luck.
Here we go. Stop! Stop at $1,000! All right, Dave, that changes the complexion a bit. You're at $1,750, one spin, two whammies. You're in second place. This is the position where you may want to pass. If you do, they go to Shirley.
I'll press my luck.
You're gonna press his luck. Here he goes. Looking for those big bucks.
Stop!
Stop at big bucks, and you got it! Big bucks translates to the highest amount on the screen. $4,000, Dave. All of a sudden, out of nowhere, $5,750. You also picked up a valuable spin. You're now well into first place, about 20. Well, you actually have about $3,200 more than Shirley has. You want to press your luck or pass that spin to Shirley?
Pass it.
You're going to pass it. All right, Shirley, it's a spin that you've got to take, and you got to take it now. $2,579 at stake, two whammies, and here we go.
All right. Stop.
Stop at $2,500. This is getting very interesting. Now Shirley's at $5,079. In second place today, we go over to Robert, who's got $1,265, three spins that he has to take before he can even begin to think about anything else. Robert, are you ready?
I am.
Here we go. We don't want any whammies.
Stop!
Stop at $1,200! Yeah. All right, Robert, $2,465, two more to go. Are you ready?
I am.
Here we go.
Stop!
Stop at $4,000 and a spin! All right, Robert, you have forged into the lead with $6,465. One more spin that you must take. We don't want a whammy on this one. You've got to take it. Here we go with it.
Stop!
Oh! He was waiting in the wings for someone, and he picked you. You've got four big spins left. You can still build up some dollars. No dollars now. You ready to go? Press your luck. All right, here we go.
Stop!
Stop at Bahamas. Yeah. A trip for two to the Bahamas. Six nights with a value of $2,080. That gives you a total of $2,080. Three big spins left. Robert, you want to press your luck or pass?
Press my luck.
Gonna go for that second position before he thinks about passing.
Stop,
stop at $2,000. Yeah. All right, Robert. Champ, you've built yourself back up to $4,080. You've got two spins left. You're probably going to get yourself in that second position to beat some, tap some strategy to deal with. What do you want to do? Press your luck or pass?
Press my luck.
Better press his luck. All right, you're $999 less than Shirley. A big spin, Robert.
Stop.
Stop at $500, and you picked up a spin. Ah, this game, you never know what's going to happen. You've got $4,580. You still have two spins. You are $499 less than Shirley. You pick up $500, and you wind up in second place by a dollar. Are you ready to press your luck?
Yes.
All right, Robert, here we go.
Stop.
Stop at Florida. Nice place to stop. A trip to Florida for two. We'll see what that is worth. A value of $1,650, Robert.
Yeah.
Now, let's take a look at where you are. With that, it brings you a total of $6,230, which puts you into the magic position of first place. You have one spin that you can do whatever you want with. In other words, you can pass that spin to Dave, since he is the next highest player in money, and hope that he gets a whammy and you win the game, or you can be the master of your own fate, make some more money, or just not whammy, and you will win the game and stay as our champion for the third day. What are you going to do, Robert?
I'm going to go for it.
You're going to go for it. All right, Robert, we don't want a whammy here.
Stop.
Stop it.
Yeah.
No. Get it, you're the new champion. Understand? The champion for the third day in a row. Your grand total is $7,814. And we'll be back in just a moment to find out exactly what you won right after this message. All right, here we are back today with your Press Your Luck champion, Robert, and this is your third consecutive win. And now, Robert, Rod Roddy will tell you exactly what you've won. Rod?
I sure will, Peter. Robert, we'll jet two of you from Los Angeles to the Bahamas round trip coach, where you'll spend a glorious week in Nassau, Bahamas at the famous Nassau Beach Hotel. Located on its own private white sand beach, the Nassau Beach Hotel is known for its water sports and parasailing. Then we'll jet to you and your companion round trip coach from Los Angeles to Florida for a six-night stay full American plan at the Lehigh Golf and Tennis Resort in Lehigh, Florida. Casual or elegant dining, play golf or tennis in a beautiful setting from the Lehigh Resort Hotel. And then we'll jet you and your companion round trip coach from Los Angeles to Hawaii for a six-night stay at the Maui Surf Resort Hotel on the sands of Kaanapali Beach, Hawaii, offering golf and tennis, quality guest accommodations, dancing, and island entertainment from the Maui Surf. Those prizes totaling $5,314 combined with the $2,500 in cash that you won today and the $9,818 in cash and prizes you previously won gives you a grand total, Robert, of $17,632. Right. Congratulations.
A ton of money, Robert. Well done. You're going to start looking for a tax shelter, I assume. Now, I want to thank Dave and Shirley for being with us. You played a terrific game. You were in it right to the very end, and I thank you for joining. You will not be leaving empty-handed. We've got some nice prizes for you. And, Robert, we're going to be seeing you on Monday, so have a nice weekend. Then, remember that the Whammy is really sort of a cute little guy, as long as he only shows up when someone else is spinning. This is Peter Tamarkin saying so long for Press Your Luck.
Here's what we have.